Hey everyone, it's Neil Barnhill with the Barnhill Golf Institute, helping you find your winning way. Today is our fifth episode of our Golf Weekly News show called The Drive. Got a lot of exciting topics to talk about in the golf world today, and we're going to start off with talking about the FedEx Cup Championship, the Tour Championship at East Lake Country Club in Atlanta, Georgia. We got the top 30 players from the PGA Tour playing in this event, a lot of money at stake this week, and we'll go over that, the prize money, how you can win. And we got our top 10 as we went over last week. We got Bryson DeChambeau leading the way. Number two is Justin Rose. Number three, Tony Finau. Number four, Dustin Johnson. Number five, Justin Thomas. And I'll let you read the rest of the list right here. But if one of the top five players on this list wins, they are guaranteed to win the FedEx Cup title, which is a $10 million prize. Big payoff. And I want to explain to a little bit about the point system. A winner of this tournament gets 2,000 points. Runner-up gets 1,200 points. So let's say Tiger, for example, wins the Tour Championship. That doesn't mean he wins the FedEx Cup title. So I'm going to go over some scenarios here. Let's say Tiger wins. For him to win the FedEx Cup title, he would have to have Bryson DeChambeau finish and tied for 15th or worse. He'd have to have Justin Rose finish in a three-way tie for 5th or worse. He'd have to have Dustin Johnson finish in a three-way tie for 2nd or worse. Same thing with Justin Thomas finishing in a three-way tie for 2nd or worse. And then Keegan Bradley would have to finish in tie for 2nd or worse. A lot of scenarios here. So the way the current system is laid out and the rule structure for how it's played this year is, you know, if you win the Tour Championship, that doesn't guarantee you winning the overall FedEx Cup title. But as of yesterday, they are proposing some new changes that would be some very dramatic changes to the FedEx Cup Championship next year, which would be if you won the Tour Championship, you would also win the FedEx Cup title. There wouldn't be a split way deal there. That's a proposed item right now. It's not set in stone, but that's the word coming out from the headquarters on that, which is a big change. And there's other changes too in the point system that they're wanting to let us know about as well. I'm sure we'll find out here soon enough. But man, this week we got a lot of money at place. There's over $25 million in bonus money for the 30 contestants. So let me go over the top 10 places paid for the final FedEx Cup standings after this tournament. Is the number one player to win the FedEx Cup title will receive $10 million. Wow. Number two will get $3 million. Not too shabby there. Number three, $2 million. Fourth place overall, $1.5 million. Number five will get $1 million. Sixth place gets $800,000, seventh place $700,000, eighth place $600,000, ninth place $550,000, tenth place $500,000. So, a lot of money. This is going to be an interesting tournament to watch. You can see why these guys have been grinding it out to make it to the Tour Championship. It is a big payday, and they have earned the right to come here and have a chance at that big prize. So, it's going to be fun for us golfers to watch this unfold this weekend. All right, so this weekly edition, we're going to introduce another item. We're going to do quote for the week, and please let me know how you like this quote and going forward. This week's quote for the week is, "With so many things coming back in style, I can't wait until morals, respect, and intelligence become a trend again," by actor Denzel Washington. Thought that was a pretty good quote, so let me know what you think about that. And we're going to go to our next segment, which is our rants and raves, and I would rather start off with the positive first. My rave this week is a shout out to all my fellow PGA members and teachers that are growing the game of golf. There's 29,000 of us out there, and these guys are working hard, relentless, and the ones that are doing the junior development programs, the summer camps, the PGA Junior Leagues, snag golf programs at schools, introducing golf to new people. My hat's off to you. I'm very proud to be a member and be associated with such a fine group of people. So continue doing what you're doing. I'm excited. I'm gonna be bringing the PGA Junior League this year. It's gonna be fun. I can't wait to get that going. I'm so excited about this opportunity to do that. I've been doing some junior development programs myself, some summer camps, and nothing wakes me up more in the morning ready to go than that. I mean, I love growing the game of golf. So again, rave out to all you PGA members doing a great job out there. Thank you for all the hard work you're doing. Okay, my rant. Okay, you got to bear with me on this one. Okay, I've been looking on YouTube, all the golf instruction out there, and I wouldn't say all of it, but it just seems like every video I'm pulling up the last 2 weeks, look at, lag, create more lag, lag this, lag more to get more power, shallow it out, get more shallow in your downswing to create more power, get more lag, more lag, more lag. I keep just seeing lag, 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 lag. All right, I get it. Obviously, when you look in the slow swing on a video of a great player, you see lag. But my argument is that they're not trying to create that. There's something else causing that to happen, the lag. You know, their movement going forward creates that, but their intent to hit the golf ball, like I've covered in one video with my impact bag, by just trying to hit a solid object, that happens. So creating lag in the swing is not something necessarily I've ever tried to do, or I actually really teach. It's a byproduct of something else that we're doing. There's another action causing that to happen, in my view. And like the impact bag, I use the axe analogy for chopping a tree. You know, I don't chop a tree. I'm from Georgia, so I've chopped trees before. I didn't start chopping at the tree and like, all right, a transition from the top of my axe coming down, I'm gonna create more lag here by doing this, boom, and hit the tree. I'm not thinking that. I'm making an athletic movement into that tree, throwing the axe head, moving my body weight, and it happens as a result of that. That's all I'm getting at. I think it can be taught much simpler is my idea and my thoughts on that. It just seems a bit complicated in my view. It's talking about gotta create lag at the top of the backswing starting down. I don't get it. It's something else that causes that. So, all right, that's my rant. You can let me know how you feel about that. I just got pretty fired up this week when I kept just seeing it over and over again. So, all right, I'm gonna move on. I've let it all out. I feel better now. Thank you for listening to me. Okay, my equipment review this week. Wow, this thing is really a great, it's not necessarily a club, it's more of a training aid, and it's the Speed Trout by I-Line Golf. I've been using it well over 6-7 weeks now. I've got a lot of junior players I work with. A couple of them in particular have a problem with their swing path. This thing has 4 pegs you can use, and it makes you on your backswing. It's got a straight line to take it back the first 12 to 18 inches. And when you come down on your downswing, you have to come inside those pegs to get the correct path. It's not too shallow and it's not over the top for sure. You have to have the correct path. The second thing this thing teaches you besides the swing path is how to trap the ball with it. It's got 3 places for you to put your ball for full swing. It's got a pitching place to put it and also a chipping. So if you come inside out and you have the correct swing path, but yet maybe you're leaning back or your right shoulder dips, you are gonna hit the plexiglass board. It will not hurt, it will just, you will hit it and you will hear it. That means you're dipping and probably flipping at it. So to not hit that, you're gonna have to transfer your weight into your left heel. Weight's gonna have to be transferred correctly. Your hands will have to be ahead of the club face at impact, and you will not hit the board. So it's giving you feedback on 2 great things, swing path, having the correct swing path coming down, and also your hands being in the right position at impact, which is slightly ahead of the club face at impact, trapping the ball. It's very, very good piece of training aid equipment. I really enjoyed using this, and I just wanted to share that information with you. So try it out, look it up, look at the reviews. I believe the reviews are all really good on it, so I wanted to share that with you today. And for more information and more subjects on golf, please visit barnhillgolf.com and look at all my other social media platforms as well. Thank you.